Greetings, sports fans. I'm Jackie Ray, and thanks for watching The Fumble. For all the latest news on all your favorite athletes, make sure you hit subscribe. Make sure you follow me on all things social media at JRayTheFanatic. Okay, look, I don't know where you guys are getting all this crazy Saints fan information from. First, you were saying Coleman was getting death threats from Saint fans, even though Coleman himself acknowledged that the threats were coming from fake pages. Yes! We filed a lawsuit. We knew it wouldn't get anywhere. We were just trying to make a point. Yes, we bought billboards to let everyone in the ATL know who that should be in the building, not the Rams. Those are all coping mechanisms. Even Sean Payton had to figure out some way to cope. See? Perfectly rational. You know what else is rational? Not watching the game. But now CNN is making not watching the game such a big deal that they literally wrote an entire article that says WhoDat Nation is boycotting the Super Bowl in hopes to send a message to the NFL and affect the ratings. Stop it. Stop it right now. There are 30 other teams that may not be watching because they don't have a reason to. And honestly, the Tom Brady Invitational is a little played at this point, don't you think? But for the record, we're not the only fans in the league that are still a little bitter right now. Ram fans are so mad that they are suing. Well, not the LA Ram fans, it's the St. Louis Ram fans. These are fans that are still paying for a stadium that was built in 1995, and they are saying the Rams violated Missouri's Merchandise Practice Act by misleading consumers who bought tickets and team merchandise. The suit is a class action lawsuit filed by fans who have personal seat licenses, which entitle owners to buy season tickets in a particular seat in the stadium for the duration of the license. St. Louis Rams' license lasted for 30 years, but the team only played in St. Louis for 21 years. The NFL did have to settle the case and agreed to refund the PSL owners for 30% of the cost of the license and agreed to pay attorney's fees in addition to the settlement amount. And how do you think the Raiders are gonna feel when they suddenly realize no one has a real reason to go to Oakland anymore? And I mean that in the nicest, please don't catch me outside type of way. All I'm saying is we're not crazy. We are just fans that were robbed and probably won't actually start the healing process until Monday. So, you know, WhoDat Nation, I'm here for you. Once again, I'm Jackie Ray. Thanks for watching The Fumble. Don't forget to subscribe and we'll see you next time.